So we still need a whole team. We need
defense. We need boarding. You do need a whole team. So the fact is, you have so many assets. You have money, and you have so many picks, right? So you got to translate. You got to you somehow have to cash in whatever picks you have to fill out a roster and your money. And here's the other thing: when you do that, are you landing a big fish? Like, how much are you spending? Like, how many? That's why he's got to be part of a trade.
Oh my God. So is it Ingram? Like, I'm not familiar enough with the Pelicans roster. Does Jared fit with the Pelicans roster? Is it a need that they have?
Yeah, I mean, was it Alvarado's their starting point guard over there?
Well, he's not he's like one. He's a
shooting guard. So they got Trey Murphy to third.
He's a two. Listen, they could be blown. That thing's a disaster. Zion always hurt. He got hurt again last year. Right. I mean, who knows what they're gonna do?
Wow.
Maybe it is they're looking to move him to New Orleans to where he could spread the floor.
Yeah.
There has to be another move. But let me throw this at you because we haven't really discussed this yet. Now, again, let's put aside that somebody likes McCain and wants to trade for McCain.
Mm-hmm.
Dalton Connect.
Either or, because the beginning of the draft, I didn't want to pick anyone. So, like,
well, I agree with you. You want to trade, you want to get veterans, you're looking to win. But tell me, Dalton Connect, when he fell, I got excited.
Yeah, everyone at the garage was getting excited as well.
Yeah. Everyone
thought
the watch party was packed last night.
I know.
And everyone was waiting for the Connect pick for the Sixers.
And then, of course, Woj drops the Jared McCain, 16 overall. And then we're all like, what? Really?
And
listen.
Can we all be that wrong? Because, I mean, we watched him. Even if you don't watch college basketball all year, you watch the tournament. And the kid's he looked like a player. He's the best player on his team. He's double-teamed almost the whole game. He still scored. You couldn't stop the kid from scoring.
Dropped 32 against NC State when they got eliminated. Only eight.
So it's like, what are we all missing here that these front offices are watching?
But here's the thing, though. Did you miss when we all wanted Warren Sapp and we all wanted Randy Moss and the fireman, right? Like, come on. There's been draft after draft in every sport where the consensus was right. I think these GMs fall in love with the age and they think about upside and they look at, well, he's 23.
Like, this is a ceiling, maybe? Yeah.
I mean, listen, this is how they messed up. We spent yesterday or the last few days talking about Mikal, right? Bridges. So think about that for a second. Bridges. No one, they couldn't fathom him having upside. They didn't see the upside. Tyrese Maxey dropped to the Sixers. All right? Tyrese Maxey. Here's the lesson, and it's Maxey. I remember the draft, and I go, oh, my God, Maxey's available? How's that possible? First of all, you know Kentucky players make great NBA players, right? Like, they just do. They always translate into NBA players.
Yeah.
So Maxey's just... Like, I don't care they didn't make the tournament that year or whatever the disaster happened. Oh, because there was no tournament because of COVID. Who cares? Like, you can look at if you're an NBA, you're a brilliant NBA guy, you can see that Tyrese Maxey can play. He's faster than anything, and he can shoot. What more upside you want? And yet, he lasted, so the Sixers ragged out, got lucky, and fell into his lap. Why can't Dalton Connect be Tyrese Maxey 2.0?
Slow white guy? I don't know. Doesn't translate?
First of all, he's not slow. Second of all, he's a tremendous athlete. And he's strong as all get out.
Yeah, I didn't understand the drop. I thought he was a top 10 pick. But
again, they look at these kids and they're looking for this big, massive upside. And they think, well, he's 19. He's going to grow. He's 18. He's going to grow with his body. He's going to do this. He's going to do that. I think that's what's in their head. And sometimes I think they miss the obvious.
And Edie was a surprise, too.
Like, yeah, no.
I don't think he could play at this level.
I thought he was a second rounder.
Yeah.
I honestly thought Edie was a second rounder.
Right.
I'm thinking, he can't defend.
No.
How is he going to defend?
He can't. That dude is slow. I mean, he looks slow in the Big Ten.
Well, he's plotting. He's a massive kid.
Yeah.
He's plotting. I didn't get that a little bit. But don't connect is not slow. Don't connect is a baller. Like, he's a player. He was also a focal point on your team who created his own shot, who was getting blitzed.
Blitzed.
Right? Like, don't you want the guy that in a big moment in big time college basketball is getting blitzed and still dropping 30?
Yeah.
Speaking too much.
Like, that's why I think they overthink it.
Yeah. I mean, that's what we do, cuz. We always overthink these
things. No, I'm not you. It's the GMs. Yeah. It's like, it's, you know, personnel people. Oh, let me, I don't know. He's 23. He's reached his ceiling. I mean, come on. Who's to say you can't get better from 23 to 27? I've seen it 1,000 times. There's 1,000 guys that got better from 23 to 27.
Yeah. I mean, I was just befuddled. And these, I just have to believe, I know they're wrong a lot, but there's a lot of people wrong with if Kinect comes out to be a player. There's 14 people wrong, I guess, GM and front offices. I don't know. We'll see. He looks like a plug-and-play guy. He comes out and gives you 15 minutes and contributes right away. I'll tell you one thing,
though. This was a dud of a draft.
Yeah. We all silly like the mayor. We all silly like the mayor.